from Kerala to address again. My dear brothers, sisters, friends and comrades, as well as the prisoners inside the campus. I was a lecturer in the Government Law College of Trivandrum for 4 years, and I was a lecturer in the Police Training College also. And I had my doctorate in law, just like Comrade P.K. Biju. I also have passed my JR. And I believe that I have more qualifications than your so-called Vice-Chancellor. I am not ridiculing his name, but he is, if he is willing to eat anybody's appam, what can I do? I have gone to Saudi Arabia, and even I had the opportunity to visit the jail by showing my identity card of the Member of Parliament of India. Can you believe a Member of Parliament from India, a Member of the Lower House, the MP of the Lok Sabha of India, going to Saudi Arabia and visiting a jail, and along with the superintendent of that jail, visiting the inmates and having conversation with them and receiving the representation from the people from Saudi Arabia in Dama. And here? In the Hyderabad Central University, what I see is that the gate is closed. If a vice-chancellor and the registrar and if some other officials are afraid of the students, with all humility may I say that they are not at all eligible to occupy the seats which now are closed. I am not talking about the student community, but I am talking about the academic community as a whole. In the interest of the academic community of this nation, it will be better if he leaves his seat at the earliest. A person who has been charged under IPC Section 306. For the last quarter of a century, I was a practicing lawyer. Don't worry, I am not going to make a lecture on Indian Penal Code. Because I would like to deliver a lecture for 1 hour. That's the minimum rate. But here you see, abetment to commit suicide is a cognizable offense under the eyes of law. It is a non-bailable offense and an offense triable by the Sessions Court, and for which the punishment that may extend to imprisonment up to 10 years. I am not praying that your present Vice-Chancellor, the so-called Vice-Chancellor, get all these awards altogether. But let me pay homage to your fellow being who is no more, who was killed by the authorities of this university, none other than Rohit Vemmula. I bow my head before the memory of your fellow being, your comrade, your friend, and who would have been one of the most prestigious personalities of this nation if he would have lived for another quarter of a century. Who killed Rohit Vemmula? This nation asked a question. The student community of this nation asked this question, pointing their finger to the authority of the University of Hyderabad, Central University. Who killed Rohit Vemmula? The answer everybody knows. As Comrade Rajesh and Comrade P.K. Biju has said here, the registrar cannot escape from the members of parliament. He has been here since 2:40, today 31st of March. Now when I finish my speech, it will be around 4:40 in the evening. Of course. Anyway, he has made us to sit here on this dirty soil. And many of your dresses are also dirty because your minds are pure. Your minds are pure. That is why your hands have become dirty, your thighs have become dirty, your dress have become dirty. Let them enjoy the cool temperature of the AC inside their office rooms, and let them enjoy it. If they want it, let them enjoy it forever in their respective homes and not here. I would like to express my solidarity with you. A person who is afraid of the students, a person who is afraid of the student community, a person who is afraid of the student agitation is not at all eligible to control the students, either academic or financial or administrative or even for research. That's all I would like to say. As a person from the academic community, as a teacher, who was a lecturer, if I was in the service, I would have become a professor by now. Fortunately or unfortunately, I became again and again a member of the Lok Sabha. So that is why I came here. It is, to be true, this gate is not sufficient to put a barricade before us. Because Biju, Rajesh and myself, we have been behind the bus many times. And it is very easy for us to come on this. Whether it is Telangana or Andhra or Kerala, it doesn't matter. Even if one dozen policemen came, I can handle them. And we are not afraid of any bars, behind the bars, or any punishment or anything like that. If we were afraid of that, we would not have come here. We would not have come here. Madam Issa Sattelberg, she came here. And it is, of course, to the authorities. Some of the officials are maybe here. Some of the non-teaching staff may be here. And some of the security personnel are also here. You please go and tell your registrar and other authorities. This was one of the very nicest receptions that he could offer to the members of parliament. And with whose grace they are receiving the salary every month. They are at the receiving end and we are at the giving end. We are granting the money and they are simply eating the money. Even Appa Rao is eating the money. This is a central university. This is not a private university. This is the property, this is not a family property, this is the nation's property. So, this Hyderabad Central University has to function as per the norms, under the law and the enactment passed by the Parliament of India. And I would like to say, the higher officials of a university has infringed, violated the norms, the rules of the act by which this university has been created. Here, this is a fight to protect secularism. This is a fight to protect secularism. This is a fight to protect this nation. Who is the Sankhis to question our patriotism? Who are the RSS people to question our belief in the nationhood? This is our nation. The earth is ours, the water is ours, the air is ours, this is our nation. Nowadays they say, the collar shirt you wear, it came from the foreign nations with the Britishers. The churidar, the salwar kameez that our girls they wear, it came from Pakistan. And the notion of democracy, the parliamentary democracy, the principle of socialism, the principle of social justice, etc., it came from outside. Secularism also. It is from Western, it is a Western idea. Nowadays it is good to see that they have already changed their uniform from the khaki knickers to the brown trousers. At least that is nice. But let me ask them a question. If they are talking about the so-called Arsha Bharat Samskar, what was the original traditional dress of our Arsha Bharat Munis, Rishis, etc.? It was the loin cloth. In Malayalam, we call it Koranam. So This S2L khaki wala, now the brown trouser wallas. The saffron flag hoisting people. Will they show the courage to have a route march with their dandas wearing these loincloths? It's a pity that some of the people like your vice chancellor playing second fiddle to the RSS, to the communal forces, and begging before for their mercy. We have a HRD minister, as Comrade Rajesh and Biju has just now told you, even she doesn't know what is her degree. Whether it is a BA second year failed or BCom first year failed. And she is managing all these affairs. And anyway, the ministers, they have come before the parliament on the floor of the house. They tell lies, utter lies, nothing else. Let me remind you, those who are threatening you, those who are afraid of you, that is why they are threatening you. They are afraid of you, they are afraid of your strength, they are afraid of your solidarity, they are afraid of your courage, that is why they are threatening you. They Their days are numbered. They are butchering democracy. They are murdering democracy. They are bypassing the parliamentary system. They are killing secularism. It is the knock of the fascism at the door. It is the knock of the fascism. You can hear the footsteps of the fascism, communal fascism, even in the kitchens. This has happened. I would like to conclude my solidarity speech. We will come here again. As the students of this prestigious university, it is your duty to take the pride to hoist the flag of the Hyderabad Central University high sky high. No apara will be there. His place will be in the waste bin. His place will be in the dambia. But you will be remembered. You will be remembered because you are waging a war. You are fighting all the forces, all the organs of the state. It is only you. You can protect this nation. Here, it is glad to see you all. If we have come here by around 5:30, more students are, more people, more public, they could have come here. Really sorry.
Next time you will come.
Next time we will come. And we can have a lecture of Madam Tessa Sidhilwad in the campus itself. And I hope by the time the doors will be opened and the security guards will offer the salutes and the registrar and vice chancellor may come here with the bouquet and the garland. But before that, anyway, we have decided to move the privilege motion against your vice chancellor and the minister. For refusing the appointment. Even the Rashtrapati will not refuse the appointment for the members of parliament. Even the first citizen of India will not. Even the Prime Minister will not. But here in Hyderabad University, we see. So, with all respect, we offer our invitation to your Vice Chancellor and Registrar to appear before the Parliamentary Committee. And that invitation will come at the earliest from the Parliament of India. And that we assure. When you continue this agitation, you should always bear in mind your studies, your examinations, and in all the examinations you should come with flying colors. You should come, all of you should come with flying colors. It is a revenge It is a revenge you have to do by participating in the agitation. I am not going to stop. Okay.